Hi everyone, welcome back to Online Classroom Jeku Dio. In this video, we are going to take a look at the process of absorption, transportation of digested food, and also defecation. First, let's look at absorption. If you notice that on your bath towel, there are a lot of thread projections, something that look like this. And this is actually very similar to the structure that you will find at the surface of the wall of our small intestine. And the million of little projections like this is called villi. Before we move further, I would like to clarify the meaning of villus and villi. Okay, both of these words actually mean the same thing. If it is only one of these projections, okay, only one like this, okay, they are called the villus. It is a singular form. If there is more than one villus, okay, they are called villi. That is the plural forms of the word. Okay, so villus and villi, they mean the same thing. Let's take a closer look at the villus. There are millions of villi in the small intestine wall. Why are there so many folds or so many villi? The purpose is to add to the surface area so that there's greater surface area, and also so that the absorption can happen quicker to increase the absorption rate of products of digestion. Next, if you take a look at the wall of the villus, look at this. The wall of the villus, it is actually very, very thin. How thin is it? It is as thick as one cell. And we know how small a cell is. That is how thin the wall of villus is. Why is it so thin? It is also to increase the rate of absorption. Next, there are actually a lot of blood vessels in the small intestine. Why? What is the function of these blood vessels? Their function is to transport the nutrients to all parts of your body. Next, let's take an even closer look at the villus. Alright, this is one villus. And here are the blood capillaries, and this is the wall of the villus. It is very thin, remember? Alright, and these are small size nutrients. Remember the definition of digestion? The definition is to break down big and complex food particles into smaller and simpler particles. And these are the smaller and simpler particles. They are small size nutrients and they can go through this wall of the villus. Okay, they can get through here to get into the bloodstream. If you take a look at this blood capillaries here, alright, there are already these nutrients in them, alright, so that they can be transported by the blood into the other cells throughout our body. And if you look at this one, there are the bigger and the larger particles. These are undigested food and they are too big. They cannot get through this wall to get into the bloodstream. And the thing in the middle here is called the lacteal. And what is the function of lacteal? Alright, it absorbs digested fat, that is fatty acid and glycerol. Alright, they will absorb the digested fat and they will transfer them into the lymphatic system and then into the blood circulatory system. So, food that has already been digested and that has already been absorbed through the wall of villus that can be found in our small intestine. Now what happened? How do we bring them to the other parts of our body that need these nutrients? Well, we have to learn a very big word. This word is assimilation. Okay, assimilation. What is the meaning of assimilation? It is actually the process of distributing the end products of digestion. Alright, we take all these nutrients and we distribute it to the cells in our body. That process is called assimilation. Do you still remember the end products of digestion? Let's take a look. We have glucose. Where does glucose come from? It is the end product of digestion for starch. So the function of glucose is to produce energy. Next, we have amino acid. Where does amino acid come from? It comes from digestion of protein. So the function is to form component of cells to repair the damaged cells or to replace the dead cells. And then we have fatty acid and glycerol that comes from the digestion of fat, and they will combine to form fat, which is used as heat insulator and also to protect our internal organs. Okay, these are just revision of what we have learned earlier. Well, there are actually three systems that work together to make sure that the food that we have eaten will be digested, they will be broken down so that our body can absorb them, and then they will be distributed throughout the whole body for the cells of the other parts of our body. So what are these three systems? We have the digestive system, that is the breaking down of large and complex particles into small particles so that our body can absorb them. And we also have blood circulatory system. After we break down the food, we need to transport them. Okay, so the blood circulatory system is the one that will do the transportation to the cells of the body. And then we have assimilation. This is the one that distribute, okay, that distribute the end products of digestion. For what purpose? For formation of new cells, and this is from amino acid. And then for respiration, and this is glucose. And finally, regulation of body temperature, that comes from fatty acid and glycerol. Well, after all this food has gone through the small intestine, they will move towards the large intestine. It is not the end of the journey yet, alright? So the nutrients have been absorbed. What is left go into large intestine. So what is the things that is left over from small intestine? They are actually the undigested food, and also things that are not absorbed by the small intestine. For example, fiber, waste, secretions of the digestive tract, dead cells, and water. If you notice, in small intestine, fiber is not being absorbed. We did not mention anything about the digestion of fiber. Why? If you remember the first topic in this chapter, we talk about different classes of food. Fiber is a class that cannot be digested by our body. The function of fiber is solely to stimulate the process of peristalsis. Alright? And then, also in small intestine, you will notice that there is nothing mentioned about water. Alright? But our body needs water. So where do we get water? Well, when this undigested food and also unabsorbed particles of food is moving along in large intestine, okay, what happened is water and minerals are reabsorbed into the bloodstream. Okay, so there's some absorption of water that happened in large intestine. Remember, it happens in large intestine. So when this the undigested food and the unabsorbed food that they move along in large intestine, water are being absorbed, and also minerals, of course. When water are being absorbed, what is left become solid waste, and we have entered into the last process that is called the defecation. Alright, so the solid waste is called the feces. It is called the feces, and the feces will be stored where? In rectum temporarily, until you need to go to the toilet. Okay, then they will be eliminated through the anus. Alright, so when you go to the toilet, you take a dump. Okay, the process of elimination of feces, that process is called defecation. Alright, that is the term defecation. So, finally, we have finished chapter 3. It is quite a chapter, huh? So, I will see you in the next video where we will start entering into chapter 4. So, stay tuned, okay? Bye! If you have learned something new from this video, don't forget to like and subscribe.